Hi and welcome to the WinCC Unified V17 course. I'll be your host, Bob Meads. In this course, we're going to focus on the visualization aspect of WinCC Unified version 17. In chapter 2, my first project, you're going to create your first WinCC Unified project and publish it to runtime. So you'll add a Somatic PC station and a WinCC Unified PCRT, create a couple of screens, and learn how to publish it to runtime. We'll also look at how to do an offline transfer of your project to another PC. In Chapter 3, we'll work with one of the more important objects for screen navigation, the screen window object. The screen window object allows us to show different screens and use navigation aids like buttons or drop-down lists. We'll do some pop-up examples, and we'll also show an alternate way to do navigation using different picture windows. In Chapter 4, we will take a detailed look at JavaScripting in WinCC Unified. We're going to look at many different examples of accessing tags, screens, doing navigation, and we're also going to create a debug window that will help us write scripts and debug as we go through the course. In Chapter 5, we'll take a look at parameter control. And this will allow us to create a set of recipes to upload and download to our process. And we'll create a visual interface as well as an interface for control tags. In Chapter 6, Faceplates, we'll take a look at creating UDTs and faceplates. And we'll use our color system to create a UI for our faceplates with three different color pumps and a color tank. In Chapter 7, we'll look at RT Collaboration and Certificate Manager. This allows us to distribute our SCADA application across multiple computers and use enhanced security using SSL certificates generated by the WinCC Unified Certificate Manager. We look forward to you completing this course, and if you have any questions or feedback, you can send them to me at bob.meads@iquestcorp.com.